everyone, Mama Mikey here, and today is a quick video. This is my impressions of Cooking Mama Sweet Shop for the Nintendo 3DS, so let's get right into it. Right away, this game is charming. There is sweet and catchy music playing, there are kids yelling Cooking Mama. It had me hooked right away. I have been wanting a new Cooking Mama game for a long time, and this was off to a fantastic start. The backbone of this game is under the My Shop menu. This is where you'll run your own shop selling delectable treats that you have baked and decorated. Under the Let's Make Sweets menu is where you'll be doing all of your actual baking and playing those wonderful baking mini games that we all love. Right at the beginning of the game, Mama gives you some advice. She says that if you put your heart into your baking, your customers will be happy and your shop will do well. So with that in mind, we get right to baking, and it is so much fun. It follows that traditional Cooking Mama formula of being timed for each mini game, and you need to complete your objectives within the time limit, and you will be given a medal based on your score, either bronze, silver, or gold, based on how well you completed the objective. In addition to baking, there is also a shop where you can buy decorations for your store, for your kitchen, and also buy new outfits for Mama. She explains that while you sell treats, customers will give you tickets, and that is what you spend in the decoration shop. There's also an entire category of items that can be used for taking photos of your sweets, including frames and stickers and different backgrounds for your photos. And it actually is a lot of fun to customize how you want to take your photo when you've finished a recipe. And now, talking again about baking, in this game there's still a practice mode so that you can practice specific mini games that might be giving you a hard time, and that is really helpful because, like in past Cooking Mama games, occasionally it feels like something got lost in translation and maybe the mini game description doesn't make a whole lot of sense. So it can be good to practice the mini games ahead of time so that you're not halfway through a recipe and then stuck on something and have to replay the entire recipe again just to get back to that part and maybe still not get it correct. So once you've actually completed baking a recipe, and if it's something that requires decoration, you decorate it, and then those finished treats will go on display in your shop. You'll earn new recipes as you play the game, just like in past Cooking Mama games. Usually each time you complete a recipe, you'll either have a new shop item has unlocked or a new recipe has unlocked. It's very good about rewarding you for completing recipes. Eventually, a special character will show up and she will request a certain item for you to make. Once you make that item, she will come back and she'll love it, of course. And then she'll say that she will open a brand new shop for you somewhere else in the world. And that is what the World Challenge tab is on the main menu. It'll be a specific shop, like if she requests cupcakes, it'll be a cupcake shop. And then there'll just be one mini game that you play at that shop, but these are a great challenge. They're actually rather difficult and they take a while to master, and you just want to keep beating your score and earning new records each time you play. They're actually a great deal of fun. It adds something completely new to the Cooking Mama games, and I really liked that addition. I'll say that this game feels so much more refined than past Cooking Mama games. Sometimes the games felt difficult, but it really was just because the stylus inputs just weren't working right. It really felt like a lot of the times I'm doing this action the same exact way each time, but it's only working 60% of the time. This game just feels so much more refined and smooth to play. I feel like the inputs are working so much better now. I'm not sure what they did to improve the game, but it really is just fantastic compared to the past Cooking Mama games. I'll also say that the game was designed really well in the way that if you play the recipes in the order that they unlock, they are sequenced in a way that you won't get stuck playing the same mini games over and over again. Of course, there is some repetition in the mini games. Multiple recipes require you to crack an egg, to whisk, to do different things. But if you play them in the order that they unlock, the way that they sequence the recipes, you will not get stuck doing the same mini game over and over again. It was very smart the way that they did it, so if you play the recipes in order, you won't get a ton of repetition. There's a lot of variety in the types of mini games that are offered, and a lot of new ones have been added into this game, with a lot of old favorites returning as well. The only issue I've had with the mini games is some of them just have such poor descriptions, which again I think might just be an issue with translation, but it's best sometimes to read the descriptions of the mini games first and then decide maybe I want to go practice that mini game, figure out what they want, because if a recipe has a lot of steps, it can take quite a few minutes to complete each recipe. This is a game that is great to play for 5 or even 10 minutes. You don't have to sit down for half an hour to play this game, but you'll make the most of your time if you use that practice mode to try mini games that you're unsure about. Another option in this game is the Let's Play Together menu. And with this, up to 4 players, so you and 3 friends, can all play the game together. And you don't all have to have a copy of the game. This is a download and play title, so only 1 person needs to have the game. The other 3 are able to download sort of a version of the game that they can just play with you, essentially. And it adds a whole new layer of fun to the game. It makes the game feel new again. Even if you've completed all of the recipes already, adding some friends into the mix, even just 1 person and playing 2-player, it just adds something special to the game that makes it feel fresh again. Next, I just want to talk about sound. This game has the classic Cooking Mama soundtrack, but something about it, it just sounds crisper and just newer. It sounds really good. The sound effects, there are some new ones and some that we've heard before, but they sound more refined and they don't sound outdated or annoying by any means. I love the past Cooking Mama games, but I'll say that some of the sound effects were harsh or the music could be a little bit harsh at times, but they've done something to just refine and retune that audio. It sounds really good. And it's just updated now. Just like Cooking Mama, it's almost like she's got a facelift. The only con I have with this game, and this is not an issue I have very often by any means, is that at sometimes I feel like the game is a little too easy. And I am not one to say that games are too easy, but I believe that they have relaxed the time limits in this game. So you have your mini games and you have your timer and you have to complete the mini games within the time. And that hasn't changed from past Cooking Mama games. But before, if you took a long time to complete the action, you would get maybe a silver medal. Versus if you complete the action quickly, you'd get a gold. And now what they've done is that as long as you complete the action within the time, you're eligible for a gold medal. And also you can make mistakes, so long as it's a fixable mistake, which really didn't exist in the past Cooking Mama games. If you were piping cookies onto a sheet, you know, you're making your macaroons, if you messed one up in the past games, that would just be a boo-boo, and that's that. You've lost one, you're not going to get a gold medal. In this game, they tell you how many you need to make, and if you make a mistake, they wipe it off and you can try again. So it makes it feel a little bit too easy because your mistakes are literally just wiped away and you can try again. There are some things that aren't fixable. For example, if you burn something, that's not a fixable mistake. That's going to be a bronze medal or a silver medal if you burn 1 out of a certain number of treats. But it does feel a little bit too easy now that they've relaxed the time limit and now that they've made it so that you can fix your mistakes. I don't mind that by any means, but I do think it's worth noting that if you're someone who enjoyed the challenge of, oh, I got a silver medal, I want to try for a gold, I only had, you know, 5 or 6 recipes throughout the entire game that I had to retry to get that gold medal. And while the World Challenge mode is an excellent challenge, and playing with friends is also a great challenge, I'll just say that that core game mode is a little bit too easy. And also your sweet shop. It's a lot of fun. It can get pretty chaotic once you've expanded your shop and you have a lot of customers coming in at once. But sometimes customers will ask for help and they can't find the item that they're looking for, but the item's always right next to them. And then on top of it, an arrow will point to the item anyways. So you don't even have to look for where the item is that they're looking for. I feel like that mode could have been a little bit more challenging because while it does get chaotic, it really is just very simple once you figure it out. And all it is a customer asks for an item, you tap on the customer, you box it up, and they leave. It is fun. I like the mode because it's fast-paced, but it's so simple, it doesn't feel like it takes really any work to learn it. But overall, I am very happy with Cooking Mama Sweet Shop. I love this game. I'm very happy that I purchased it. I definitely think that it's worth the purchase. But like I said, if you're someone who enjoyed retrying the recipes in the past, maybe this is a game for you to rent first or to wait and buy it used, because it's an excellent game. I'm having a lot of fun with it. You definitely can add a whole new way to play once you play with other people, and that world challenge mode is a lot of fun. But it might seem a bit too easy if you're a veteran of the Cooking Mama games and if you really enjoyed the tough challenges of the past games. So let me know in the comments below if you picked up this game and what you think of it. Like, comment, subscribe if you want to see more, and I'll see you next time. Bye!